Derek Tony, VarsitySportsNetwork.com. We're here at Milford Mill Academy. We're at the Franklin Indians, the defending Class 3A state champions, and they just flexed tonight over here against their rivals, the Milford Mill Academy Millers. An impressive 42-7 victory. They put up a running clock on the Millers. Didn't see that one coming as they again put together probably one of their best performances I've seen in my 15 years of covering this program that has become the best public school program in the area, and they showed why tonight, 42-7 over Milford Mill. I have three key guys with me. To my left, senior Jonathan Smith, 14 carries for 113 yards, including a touchdown where he just carried all of Baltimore County with him into the end zone. In the middle, QB1, senior Vernon Smith, 13 of 19 for 168 yards and four touchdowns. And next to him, led the defensive line, senior Amani Austin, as the Franklin defense shut down a very potent Milford Mill offense, as again, almost flawless in a 42-7 victory over Milford. And we'll start with Amani. Amani, man, just talk about the growth in this team. Last time I saw you guys got handled by McDonough. But tonight, man, I mean, you guys obviously have made a lot of corrections and put together a pretty much a dominant performance.
So, our first two goals on defense is alignment assignment. First two, once you have your alignment, you have your assignment. We got humble from the McDonough game getting blown out. That made us humble. And, the defense was lights out today. Outstanding.
What did you guys do special? I mean, obviously you guys were able to get pressure up the middle, pressure on the ends against Rashawn Holmes. Talk about that and some other things you guys were able to do to just keep Milford's offense. They just really didn't do anything tonight.
I think we had three picks. Sire Hopkins, Wayne Brooks.
Who's third one?
And Scoop, I think. Mm-hmm. So, shut down number one, the quarterback.
Right. Had a couple of sacks there. I mean, just talk about your performance.
That performance was something.
Reflecting tonight, man.
Not too much. I'm not done yet. Just getting started.
Right. And also getting started, this guy, Vernon Smith, senior quarterback. You know, a year ago, you took over the starting role full-time, and you've just matured. And tonight, you know, 13-19 for 168 yards. Just talk about just the offense. I mean, offense, you guys just were able to do whatever you want tonight.
We just watched a lot of film and knew what they was going to come out with. And we had the right plays to execute and get the ball in the end zone.
This doesn't happen without your offensive line, man. Talk about the guys up front.
They put in so much work over the practices and over the weeks to be dominant and not let defense get inside.
And talk about your growth. Now you're the leader. This is your team. This is your, you know, there's no doubt you are the guy to run this offense. Talk about this just getting better and better every game.
Just staying focused and being humble.
You guys played a perfect game tonight. You know, this was the first game that all the coaches said, you know, we didn't have to, you know, you guys kind of knew what you had to do. Wasn't have to make any, you know, hey, move there, whatever. All your alignments were perfect, man. Just talk about that.
Just watching film, staying ahead in the film, knowing what the defense about to do, know what the other team about to do. Right. You go out there, not looking clueless.
Right. And Jonathan Smith, man, that touchdown run kind of set the tone tonight. Just kind of take us through that play.
Basically, when I got the ball, we started out in an unbalanced formation. Mm-hmm. So immediately I thought, since we got more manpower, bounce it to the outside. I saw one of their DBs or outside linebackers come. They tried to make a low tackle. I had to, you know, basic running back tools, get my knees up, get through there. And after that, you know, people kept coming on me. You know, you just gotta lift your knees up and drive. And, you know, you gotta trust all the work that you do in the weight room. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I just dominated my will on that run.
All right. Tell about the offensive line. I mean, a lot of holes tonight.
Mm-hmm. I mean, they work hard. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, everybody makes mistakes. They blocked for me very well tonight. You know, despite the holes, you know, I'm a running back. I'm nothing without my line. So, you know, props to them.
Right. And just talk about just the growth in this team. This team has shown from that McDonough loss. That was a humbling loss, and it seemed like that has woke you guys up. And like I said, tonight, you guys played a near-perfect game.
I mean, when you lose like that, you know, you can either be defeated or you can work harder. And, you know, my team, we came and we were tighter than ever. You know, and that's what it all boils down to at the end of the day.
Right. Well, you get a few days off too, and to savor this a little bit. You'll savor it tonight and Saturday and Sunday, but back to work next week. Talk about just continuing to get better.
I mean, you know, we got a lot of games left. You know, I plan on keep improving. My team plans on keep improving. You know, you're just going to see a better Franklin football as the season goes on.
All right. Well, he's a senior running back, 14 carries for 113 yards. You got to see his touchdown run. One of the better runs I've seen in a minute. Jonathan Smith, another senior. Vernon Smith, QB1, 13 of 19, 168 yards, four touchdowns, and leading the defense, another senior, Amani Austin, as he had a couple of sacks as the Franklin defense shut down the Milford Mill offense. And guess what? The rivalry that is Milford and Franklin, it is still strong, but on this night, Franklin just flexed 42-7. For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Tumney.